Welcome everyone to our YouTube series, Test Prep Made Easy. So in this particular series, we are going to post regularly questions on our YouTube channel. The questions may pertain to CAT preparation, may be pertaining to GMAT preparation, as well as of various topics which are tested in these particular exams. For example, Quants, LRDI, English, and various areas which are tested. And each day, we will handle certain number of questions and their video solutions. The best approach is to these questions in these videos. So have a happy preparation ahead and enjoy the video. Thank you.
Okay, so this is the LR set that we are going to discuss in this video. Hopefully you have already tried it from the thumbnail itself. If you haven't, you can pause the video at this point. We recommend you to try it once before you watch the solution. And if you just want to enjoy the solution, you're welcome to do the same thing. Just go ahead and watch the solution, which will be starting now. All right, this is a very straightforward set. I'll just represent or explain a few things before I get into the question, because a very, very easy set out here. This diagram is representing the distribution of the number of students of a class who passed in one or more subjects out of the four different subjects, whatever I presented. So this is a sort of a Venn diagram where the shapes, different shapes are indicating the different subjects out here. You always have to check this part, the legends out here. So I think the shape itself should be evident. Sort of a rectangle thing. So this seems like the rectangle one, which is indicating the English. The square thing should be this one, which is indicating the Hindi. Then you have the mass as a circle and the triangle as the physics, right? So these are the subjects out there. And obviously it is representing the number of students who have passed in these subjects and all. So for instance, there's 22 students out here have passed only in the square thing, which is the Hindi, right? So 22 have passed only in Hindi. The 7 out here is part of the circle as well as the square. So 7 has passed in the circle and the square, so which is maths and Hindi. So effectively in that way, we can figure out everything out here, right? Whichever is required. Also, there's a note out here. So do not miss that out. So the note says that in the figure above, the number of students belonging to any particular combination, that is combination of subject passing grade, which is not shown is 0. For instance, so this part, there is no number indicated. So this part is, by the way, what? It's part of the rectangle and the circle, not the square, not the triangle, right? So it is part of the rectangle, so passed in English, part of the circle, passed in maths, not in Hindi, not in physics. So effectively, this section should have represented those students which have passed in English and maths only. So that is missing, but I see that there is this value as well, this 7, which is again part of the rectangle and the circle. So sometimes this trick kind of thing happens. So in these kind of questions, I've seen sometimes that they'll mention a 6 year and a 7 year. So both of these are actually the same thing in terms of region, because they are both part of the circle and the rectangle, but not part of triangle and not part of square. I hope you can see that. So those kind of tricks you have to avoid here. But ideally what this note thing is telling us is if there is any combination missing, so that is 0. You can consider that to be 0. Great. So nothing has been missing. So everything has been mentioned. So let's quickly get into the questions. So first question is looking for how many students passed in at least one subject among Hindi and English, but failed in at least one subject among maths and physics. So what I quickly do is in these kind of cases, I always look at the legends. So Hindi and English are the square and rectangle. So if it has to pass in at least one subject among Hindi and English, right? So what I immediately know is those numbers which are not part of the rectangle as well as not part of the square, they can be ignored. So which are those numbers? So let us look at this. So this 11 I can see is not part of the rectangle or the square. This 15 is not part of the rectangle or the square. So those things can be excluded straight away, right? If it is part of any one of them, that can be included. So keep that in mind. Also, this 5 is not part of the rectangle or the square. So these numbers can be straight away excluded out here. So we can simply exclude these numbers. There is another constraint, and that says that these students should have failed in at least one subject among the remaining two, right? So implies that it cannot be part of both the circle as well as the triangle, right? Because those which are, you know, both part of the circle and the triangle, they have passed in both of these subjects. So they are also not allowed to be counted. So for example, this 2, this is part of the circle as well as the triangle. This 4, that is also part of the circle and the triangle. This 13 is also part of the circle as well as the triangle. So these numbers have to be excluded. So we cannot count these numbers. So all you have to do is count all the remaining numbers out here. Now, I know when you are solving this question, you cannot do this. So this is just for your visual purpose. So what you can do is when you're reading the question, you can just take note in this manner. So what you can do is you can first ignore this 15, this 11, you can strike it off separately. This 2, 4, 13, you can, okay, 5 was out also this. So there are a couple of repetitions also this, there are a couple of 7s out here, don't get confused there. But this 5 will also be excluded. Then this 2, 4, 13 will also be excluded. So you can keep separate notes for that. So you can exclude these numbers, right? And then you can count the remaining numbers. So for this example, we will carry on with the visual thing. So I'll just show that because that is a little visual enough. So if you have a bit of practice, the idea is that you can ignore those numbers and just take a note of the other numbers. So you can just write in your rough copies these numbers which are satisfying the constraint and just add it up. That's all. So in this case, let us quickly do this. So 22 and 22 is 44. And then you have 717. So 7 is 14 and then there's a 1. So that is 15. So you have 44 and 15, which is adding up to 59. So 59 is none of the options. So the answer has to be option D, none of the aforementioned. So the numerical value is not given. So the answer for this is option D. So I hope the visual part was easy enough to understand. Let's quickly move to the next one now. Okay, so this says if every student who failed in not more than one of the above mentioned 4 subjects gets promoted to the next class, then how many students are promoted to the next class? Okay, so indirectly what it says is those students who have passed in at least 3 subjects, right? So you're not supposed to fail in more than one subject. So you need to pass in at least 3 subjects because there are a total of 4 subjects out here. See, I'm just converting this to the past in number of subjects idea, because that is what the data is directly provided for, right? So as long as I know that the student is not supposed to fail in more than one subject, so you can fail in one subject, but more than one subject is not allowed. So you need to pass in at least 3 subjects, right? So you have to pass in 3 subjects or all the subjects. So this is what we are looking for, how many students are satisfying this criteria. So basically we're looking for those kind of numbers which are part of 3 figures or more, or all the 4 figures, right? So either it is part of 3 of the figures or it is part of all the 4 figures. So let us look at this. So 22 is just part of the square, so you can ignore that. 7 is also part of the square and the circle, but it is not part of the rectangle or the triangle, so ignore that. Now this 1, the 1 is part of the square, the rectangle as well as the circle. So keep a note of this 1. Okay, so we'll just do layer by layer. Look at the 16. The 16 is only part of the rectangle, so ignore that again. Now look at this 4. So this 4 is part of the square, the triangle, and the circle. It is not part of the rectangle, but it is part of 3 figures, right? So the 4 can also be taken into account. So 4 is fine. The 2 is part of everything, actually. So the 2 is definitely coming in. 11 out here is part of the circle and the triangle. So only 2 figures, not 3 figures, right? So ignore 11. The 13 is part of the triangle, the circle, and the rectangle. So 13 is definitely coming in. This 6 is part of 2 of the figures, the triangle and the rectangle. So ignore that. 5 is only the triangle. Ignore that. Okay, 15 is only part of the circle. So we should ignore that. 7 is part of the circle and the rectangle, right? 7 is part of only the circle and the rectangle. So just 2 of the figures. So don't take that into account. So we have these numbers only. Simply add them up and you'll get the answer. 142 is 7. 7 plus 13 is 20. So that is option D. So pretty straightforward again. Just have to visualize this. Just interpret this as simply as possible in terms of the figure that is given. And then look for the numbers. So that will be easy enough to solve. So that's it for this problem. Let's move to the next one. Okay, so this one says how many students failed in at most two of the above mentioned four subjects. Okay, failed in at most two. So if a person is failing in at most two, he is passing in at least two, right? Something like that, because there are four subjects. If somebody fails in at most two subjects, so it has to be something like this, fails in at most two subjects, then passes in at least 4 minus 2, which is also two subjects. So we are looking for those who have passed in two subjects or more. Now I have unfortunately taken my rougher for the previous problem, but you can just go back. I remember the numbers that I took there. So it was 1, 2, 4, and this 13. So these were the numbers which were passing in three subjects or more. So this is something you should already have in your rough work when you're solving this problem, right? So you can refer back to that. So those numbers are again allowed to be counted, because if you remember, these were the students who have passed in at least three subjects, right? So this is already done. All we have to figure out is the number of students who have passed in exactly two subjects. So if I have figured out this, then I can just add it to this 20 and get our answer. So this time around, we are additionally looking for those numbers which are present in two figures, because three figures or more we have already accounted for in the previous question. So let's do that quickly. 7 is part of two figures, circle and the square. 22 is not, by the way. It's only part of the circle. The square. So 7 is definitely. So this 7 is part of the circle and the square. 16 is part of only the rectangle, so ignore it. 1, 2, 4, 13, we have already accounted. 11 is part of the triangle and the circle. So that is two figures. So take the 11 also. 13 is part of the rectangle as well as the circle. So 13 should also be, okay, 13 we have already considered, right? Also the rectangle, yeah. So three figures, we have already taken that into account. The 6 is part of the rectangle and the triangle. So add that as well. 5 is only the triangle, ignore that. The 7 is part of the circle and this rectangle. So this 7, by the way. So both the 7s are actually being counted. So don't get confused. The first 7 was this one and the 7. Both the 7s are actually part of two figures. 15 is part of only the circle. So ignore that. So this is the additional thing. So 7, 7 is 14 plus 6 is 20 and plus 11 is 31. And this was 20. So 20 plus 31 is 51. That should be the answer, option A for this question. So that's it for this problem. This is very similar to the previous one. I hope everything was understood. Let's move to the next one. All right. In this one, you're looking for how many students passed in maths but failed in English. Okay. This is a very simple, very straightforward one. So maths is the circle, right? That is what is given. And English is the rectangle. So we are looking for those which are part of the circle but not part of the English, or that is the rectangle, right? So not part of the rectangle. So that is what the question is talking about. So what I'll do is I'll first check all the numbers in the circle. So this entire block is what we are looking for, but the rectangle should not be accounted for. So this section goes off. So this is the visual thing. So it's very fast actually. So I hope you were able to see that. So I'm just first focusing on the circle because they have to pass in maths. That is a primary criteria. But then among them, it has to also fail in English, right? So just ignore the part which is passing in English. So don't count that part. So effectively, we have this 7, 4, 11, and 15. So this is what we are trying to add up, right? So this is also 11. 11 plus 11 is 22 plus 15 is 37. So pretty straightforward one again. So these are the questions for this question, for this particular set. So you can treat this as a DI one only, because every data is presented and you have to just figure out question by question. So it's a pretty straightforward one, not too much of reasoning also involved. You just have to properly allocate the data and get the answers for whatever question is looking for. So that's it for this particular set. I hope every question was understood. Thank you for joining in.
Hopefully you liked the solutions we provided for these questions. And if you did like it, do not forget to like the video and share, subscribe and comment. Do subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon. In that case, you'll get notification as soon as we upload a new video. And if you want to check a bouquet of courses that we provide, so we have a huge variant of courses from customizability to full preparation, you can check our website, www.mathoratory.com. I'll leave the link in the description below. And have an enjoyable preparation ahead. Welcome to the Mathoratory family and have a good exam ahead.